actress named Sally B.
Thank you.
fighters of the European theatre alongside Lockheed C-38 Lightning and the North American P-51 Mustang. Successful in other theatres as well.
I didn't expect it to be.
And compared with pretty much any other Second World War single engine, single seat fighter, it makes them look almost small and the P-47 going through its paces, a Sally B comes in from there. Demonstrated in typically elegant fashion by Duxford. But as for the P-47, this is an aircraft that weighs 7 tons. There were multi-engine light bombers and strike aircraft that weighed less than that. It was also a design that took quite a long time to perfect. At the outset, it wasn't particularly long range. And nor was it very good in the low-level regime. But in the escort fighter role at high altitudes, it really came to prove its worth. And then when the P-47D model came along that we see here, that was when the design really began to achieve its potential.
Thank you.
sufficient ground. When it appears, this aircraft will be quite upset.
Today.
Catalina.
Going supersonic.
This aeroplane really does typify the qualities that you need in a good training aeroplane. Certainly advanced trainer role.
Thank you.
to the report fighter group stationed in Devon. Stationed at various locations around Italy.
number of extraordinary records, which we will tell you about later. Now, this team is led by Phil Hardesty, the team leader, and he's been displayed flying for 5 years, and he's been flying since the age of 10. We might ask him how that was possible at some point. Number two is Clive Denny. And Clive is a displayed pilot. He's very good pilot.
American L4
most significant historic aeroplane flying today.
Bird dog flying it in behind.
Spitfire, DR-11, and they're running in now.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And among the aircraft types used by its US Army Air Service during what remained of the 1914-18 conflict were the two types that we see in the lead here, the SE-5A and the U-417. The air in 2008, and it's been finished as one of von Richthofen's while he was flying with Yasta, or Fighter Squadron 11, specifically an aeroplane in which he scored 9 of his 80 kills. 417 was still flying with
thank you.
typical Chelsea series production. In large part, the commonality with the earlier T-36. The early T-40's performance wasn't the best. It wasn't a very good high-altitude fighter. But when these aircraft were entering service in 1940 and then, by the standards of the day, they were long range and they were always very maneuverable at low level. explains the fact that we've got a few of them, four different variants, the four big eggs, French Avril Air, Hawk 75, airworthy gentlemen, really placed a new focus on the success that these aircraft did enjoy, which saw P-40s achieving true air superiority for the Allies in the China, Burma, India or CBI theatre, and great successes in the Mediterranean, North Africa and the Middle East. Air Force in the Southwest Pacific.